Sheet of paper. themselves where no one can disturb them. Leave a window open and take the key out of the keyhole and hang it over the chimney piece. Have a good fire and place in the midst of it a long thin log of wood, well sprinkled with oil, salt, and fresh mold. Then wrap the chain around each maiden having an equal share in the business. Then sit down, and on your left knee, let each fair one have a prayer book opened at the matrimonial service. Just as the last acorn is burned, the future husband will cross the room. Each one will see her own proper spouse, and he will be invisible to the rest of the wakeful virgins. Those that are not bewed will see a coffin or some misshapen form. Oh Jesus, so if you don't get married, you might as well just die. Cross the room, go to bed instantly, and you will all have remarkable dreams. This must be done either on a Wednesday or Friday night, but no other. So, a cool little idea of what to do next time. You get together with your friends and just, you know, I mean, you might die, but no, I'm just kidding, that's not what it says. But, oops. Yeah, the next one is called Love's Cordial. And then Love Letters after that one, too. So it seems the first part, at least, of the book is more towards, like, love spells and related to that, which I still find interesting, but I'm sure as we go on, there's gonna be other witchier categories, if you will. So, yeah, let's read Love's Cordial. It seems like this one may be like a little poem, so let's read that. on receiving a love letter that has any particular declaration in it, lay it wide open, then fold it in 9 folds, pin it next to your heart, and thus wear it till bedtime, then place it in your left hand glove, and lay it under your head. If you dream of gold, diamonds, or any costly gems, your lover is true.
Time of rising. You may keep the rose under.